What would you do if you received a briefcase full of money, $101,000 to be exact, and you're told you can keep it, share it, or give it away to another family in need? What role would your faith play in this life-changing decision? Well, that's the premise of a new show on CBS called The Briefcase. Take a look.
What would you do if $101,000 landed on your doorstep? Now comes a new series that will make you question what really matters most. Each week, two deserving families that have been dealt a tough hand will be given a briefcase with $101,000 inside. But with the $101,000 comes a life-altering decision.
The money is yours, but there also is a decision.
You can keep all of the money, you can keep some of the money, or you could choose to give all of the money away.
If you decide not to keep it all, what's ever left is gonna go help another family who may be in as much need, or maybe more, than you guys.
This is The Briefcase.
Well, Gabriel and Crystal Moya from Albuquerque, New Mexico, actually faced that difficult decision, and they join us now with more to talk about it. You guys have six children, you homeschool, and you face some tough economic times. Tell us about that.
So every day is definitely a challenge, but we face every day with our Lord helping us get through it. Economical is your bit.
Well, we're a one-income family. I'm the breadwinner. And as of late, when we, we had four children, and our latest one was a surprise pregnancy. And lo and behold, the Lord blessed us with twin boys. So along with the blessing, there was some shock with that. But the pregnancy was definitely a difficult time for us.
Yeah. Tell us your reaction, Gabriel, when you first received this money.
We had signed up for a documentary of sorts, not knowing what was really going to happen. The producer shows up with the briefcase.
We had no idea about the $101,000. No. We just thought it was a documentary about them.
Crystal, the show gives you a choice to give some or all of the money away to another needy family, and it gives you glimpses of that other family's life. Did that make your decision easier or harder?
Well, I think both in a sense, because, you know, my initial thing with another family is, like, help them, you know? So it was easy and hard, and it was definitely an emotional roller coaster.
Wow.
For me.
Gabriel, what was your reaction?
We've been very blessed throughout our lives through the things we have, the things we, you know, our children. We've received many, many blessings from other people, and at no point, you know, could we keep all of the money. Mm. So it came down to looking at numbers and having conversations we hadn't really had. So in a sense, it did bring us closer.
And especially closer to our Lord, which we, you know, we thought we were close to our Lord, and even more so. I mean, we prayed so much throughout this journey.
How did that affect your decision-making process in terms of what to do with the money?
Initially, we found out about another family who had children who needed help. So right away, we're saying, yeah, we need to help them. The thing was, how are we going to do this? But over the 72 hours, they give you more information about the family, and it turns out the family they paired us with doesn't exactly practice our beliefs. It was a transgender lesbian couple, if I may say that. So that also had us praying and thinking more about the money. But
it's not every day that you're given this amount of money. And then that you're kind of faced with, oh, I got to find my faith in this. Like, Lord, these are your children, but how do you want us to show them your love? Through it all, we found our Lord even more. We had to look at that. We're all God's children. We're not judging. We all sin, you know. So that was a hard pill to swallow. But it also, we had to stay true to our faith and that we don't support this lifestyle. So how can we show God their love?
But what did you both learn from this incredible experience?
You know, I don't know for myself that, you know, it did bring us together as a couple, definitely. But even more so, I just learned to call on God even more. So, I mean, every day we were in prayer, and every day we pray to get through the day. But even more so, we were like, okay, Lord, like, help us through this journey.
you know, it brought it to life for me. We see it on television. You hear about these things all the time. The media's plugging, you know, all this lifestyle. This was right in our face. It was a decision we had to make, putting your money where your mouth is. So it really, really, it really, really brought us together in prayer. And, you know, it was as real as it gets. It really was.